Well, I say we go ahead and get started. Because why not? So, everybody that's been here before, you know the drill. You comment or ask a question, and you'll be entered to win a set of juggling balls. This week, Flying Clipper is our sponsor, and Jim sent me some really sweet juggling balls that actually are not on his website. They're a prototype. This is them right here. They're an underfilled steel pellet ball, 120 grams. I took them from a test run last night, and I really like them a lot. We'll talk more about those in a little bit. Ty, I was wondering if you could tell us more about yourself. First, where are you from?
I'm from Las Vegas, Nevada, born and raised.
And how long have you been juggling?
How long have I been juggling? So half my life, I guess, 9 years.
Okay. And what are you most excited about when it comes to juggling right now?
Right now, I'm most excited to juggle 9 balls behind my back and qualify it.
Is that something that you've done?
I don't think I've qualified it. I've just juggled 9 balls behind my back for more than 9 throws and caught them.
But you think that that is on the horizon?
Yeah, once my shoulder heals, because right now it's kind of injured and it hurts a lot to do it.
Yeah.
So right now I'm just perfecting technique slowly mm-hmm. with 1 or 2 balls.
Okay. Yeah. How did you injure your shoulder juggling?
Yeah, I was I just had 2 months off from the circus, and then I came back to the circus and started practicing again because I don't know, I did not practice at all during my 2 months off because I just wanted to do nothing. So I started immediately doing 9 balls, and then I injured myself because I wasn't ready for it. My body was not physically ready.
That's crazy. I haven't gotten to the point in my life where I can injure myself juggling. So,
oh yeah.
So I am impressed with that. Is that something you're proud of, or are you really just kind of bummed?
No, I'm bummed because I don't know. I'm really motivated now.
Yeah.
I haven't been so motivated in a while, so it sucks when I injure myself because you know I just want to practice every day, get better.
So you said you've been juggling since you were 9. Why'd you start?
I started because I had a stepfather who was also a professional juggler, and I wasn't really doing anything back then. I was just going to, I don't know, what grade of school am I in at 9 years old? Is it first grade, second grade, whatever. Whatever it was, third or fourth. I just was coming back home from school and watching TV and basically doing nothing else. I didn't really have any friends to hang out with. So I was watching SpongeBob or whatever, and he told me you should take 1 hour of TV time and spend it juggling or learning something. So he taught me how to juggle 3 balls.
Okay. And that was when you were 9, and from there it just kind of took off? You challenged yourself to keep on going?
Yep, basically, with his motivation as well. So slowly created a routine and worked on it, learned new tricks.
Mm-hmm. How long did it take you to, I don't know, juggle 5 balls?
To juggle 5 balls? I don't really remember. It's all a blur. So, 9, 10. Maybe 2 years.
Okay.
I think because I think when I was 9, I could juggle 4, and then 10. Oh wait, maybe I learned it less than 2 years. I think I learned it less than 2 years because when I was 9, I was like flashing 5,
mm-hmm.
and getting it up, you know. So yeah, probably when I was 10. So a year and a couple months before I could juggle 5.
Okay, cool. So I mean, it was pretty quick. So Were you performing like when you were in middle school and high school?
Yep, I was already performing.
Okay.
I started performing when I was 9. I was like a guest appearance in my stepfather's act.
Okay.
So I came out in the middle of his act and I did a short routine and then I went away.
And you said you've been juggling for half your life. So does that make you 18 or 19 now?
I'm 18, but okay, a little bit more than half my life now because I'm turning 19 in 1 week.
Okay, happy birthday.
Thank you.
And you're already traveling the world and performing. So when did you start that?
9 years old. Everything started when I was 9. I went to the Bahamas. And I performed in a circus in the Bahamas. That was my first performance. And then after that, where did I go? I did some gala in Las Vegas. And then I think at like 11 or 12, I went to Germany to work in a circus building for Circus Krone. And ever since then, I've been traveling around and working.
How has that worked with school?
Oh, I was homeschooled from 3rd grade on.
Okay.
Yep.
Sweet.
Yep.
Well, I don't know if you think that's sweet or not, but.
Yeah, it was kind of boring, to say the least. I didn't have any friends, really, so I was just... I was playing World of Warcraft a lot.
Yeah. Yeah.
I was playing World of Warcraft, juggling, and studying. That's about it.
Okay. Yeah, I was actually homeschooled too, so I can sympathize with you.
But I wasn't one of the smart homeschooled kids, so.
No, me neither. All right. Well, what do we got here? What do we want to talk about tonight? Oh, yeah. I wanted to just say, like, a special thank you, Ty, for coming on. I feel like you're one of those people in the community that we all know is crazy good, and you have these crazy back cross records. But we don't really know who you are that well, so I'm just excited that we get to spend some time with you. So thanks for agreeing to come on.
No problem. It's fun.
So I want to hear about a moment where you knew that juggling was a good thing for you to be doing. Were you like, maybe you didn't like, weren't at a point where you're like, this is who I am, I'm supposed to be a juggler, but where you were like, you know, this is having a good impact in my life.
Mm-hmm. Probably when I was 14 and I performed in Monte Carlo, probably the biggest circus festival in the world, and I met like my first friend, I guess you could say. So at that moment, I was like, yes, I get to travel, I get to meet new people, I get to make friends and, you know, see really cool things. At least that's what I was thinking about for juggling, because I don't know, juggling was kind of like a job for me. So that was in my mind, and that's when I really thought like, yes, I'm happy, I'm a juggler, and this is what I want to do.
Totally. What's a really, I don't know, you were talking about how you're excited to be able to travel and have these experiences. What's a really memorable experience you've had traveling and performing?
It's a hard one. Well, I just went on like a, because I'm in Germany when I'm not working now. So from Germany, I traveled to see my friend working in a place called Cirque d'Hiver, and he works with elephants. So I was able to get on top of an elephant and juggle 7 balls, and that was pretty cool. So right now, that's what's in my memory. Probably some other things too, but I can't think of them right now.
Mm-hmm. How have you seen juggling change your life for the better? Just one way.
Change my life for the better. I mean, physically, I'm very fit and healthy because of juggling. I get a lot of cardio every day.
Mm-hmm.
And all the other things that we've talked about, like being able to travel and to make a living from it.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, meeting new people.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's about it.
How have you seen it impact other people's lives for the better?
All the other jugglers that I really know, they seem to really enjoy juggling a lot. And it gives them a lot of happiness. And yeah, I don't know. It's a really, really good, healthy hobby, and it's fun. So yeah, I just see a lot of other people who juggle and they really enjoy it and it makes them happy.
Yeah, sweet. Hey everybody, don't forget that if you ask a question, you'll be entered to win a set of balls from Flying Clipper. Flying Clipper is an awesome company. Oh, by the way, if you don't win, you can still get that sweet discount if you go to flyingclipper.com/EJ. So make sure you check that out. What are you holding there?
A club from Renegade. And yeah, I just bought it. It's very cool. I'm going to start to learn how to juggle it.
So we were talking before, you've spent most of your time focusing on balls. And now you want to know what clubs are all about?
Yeah, there's a lot of people who enjoy them. I see many, many, many club jugglers and people doing crazy things with them. So I want to, yeah, try. I probably won't do any crazy things, but at least I want to learn how to juggle at least 5 or 7 of them.
Mm-hmm. Sweet. Well, let's do a few questions from the crowds. From Ivan Drags Show. Can you mention some of your records? So what are some ball records that you have?
I think I have the 5-ball backcross record, the 6-ball backcross record, the 7-ball backcross record, and maybe the 8. I think I have 3 for sure. Those okay. Backcross records, yeah. And hopefully soon the 9-ball record. I sent it to Guinness, but they didn't think that it was a record. They thought it was just a trick.
Hmm.
So I need to make more than 9 throws behind my back and catch them, or you know, I'll just qualify it and then I'll send them that video and then they cannot deny that it's a record.
Right.
So I'll do that eventually. Yeah. Hopefully soon.
Now you spend a lot of time on back crosses, or you've got these back cross records, so presumably you spend a lot of time on them. What is it about back crosses that you're attracted to?
Early on in my career, my stepfather, he asked me what trick I liked and what trick I thought, you know, was good looking and would look good to like an audience or a crowd. So we both decided on back crosses, and then ever since then, back crosses has kind of been like my final trick in my routines.
Mm-hmm.
Like I end my 5-ball routine doing 5-ball back crosses while turning in a circle, and then I end my 7-ball routine just doing 7-ball back crosses for like 15 throws or 20 throws.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of why, because it's my last trick.
Okay. It's your last trick. It's the trick you wanted to focus on. It's also a really beautiful trick. I don't know if that's part of it for you too.
People can see it when they watch it. They can see the difference going from just a normal 7-ball pattern to back crosses, and yeah, for them it's really, really nice to look at. So that's why we picked it.
Mm-hmm. Quinn Lewis, what draws you to high numbers? And are there any 3 or 4 object patterns that you enjoy juggling or watching?
What draws me to high numbers? 7 is not that high.
Well, Quinn Lewis is known for his Quinn Lewis is known for his three ball stuff, so seven probably sounds pretty high to him.
Ah, okay. Well, I don't know. I think when you're juggling for people, they expect you to juggle a lot of things. So I think that's why I juggle more things, because it's what people expect, and I kind of expect it too. But obviously there's other types of juggling, so artistic and other good-looking juggling.
Yeah.
But I just haven't really focused on that.
Yeah.
What was the other part of the question?
So the question was, are there three or four ball patterns that you enjoy doing or watching?
Oh, three or four ball patterns. I don't really juggle four balls so much. Three ball pattern, I enjoy doing the reverse back crosses with three balls, throwing them from the front and catching them in the back. I want to learn that with five. What else? I don't know. I enjoy the box. You know, this box. I do it a lot because in the circus that I'm in, I have to juggle three balls for like 30 minutes while the people are walking into the circus. So I do a lot of fun tricks like that, and that's what I enjoy.
From Daniel Simu, are you interested in visiting some juggling conventions?
Yeah, I want to go visit EGC this year, but I just found out that I have to be back to practice for this show on the 26th, and EGC starts on the 22nd, right? Or yeah, I think it starts on the 22nd. So I would only be able to be at EGC for like 2, maybe 3 days before I have to come back to Germany. And I don't know if it's really worth it. Maybe you guys can tell me if it's worth it.
Yeah. If you guys think it's worth it to go to EJC for a couple of days, let us know in the chat box.
Yeah.
Another one from Daniel. Do you juggle for fun as well, or just as your work?
When I'm practicing, the goal is to juggle for work, kind of, but I have fun practicing, so I guess it's combined into one.
Yeah.
Yep.
Totally. Which is great.
Yep.
Now, a question I have for you, you talked about how you've been juggling since you were 9, and your stepdad, I think you said, talked to you or showed you how to do it, and then you started performing with him. So from the beginning for you, it's been, I don't know, I guess you've had deadlines from the beginning. You've had things that you've had to learn from for the next performance.
Yeah.
Do you think that that's taken the fun out of juggling for you at all?
Well, yeah, because I was basically being taught like it was a job since I was very small. So I've always kind of thought about it as a job until very recently.
Mm-hmm.
And now I'm starting to see the more creative and fun side of it.
Mm-hmm.
When before I was just exactly what you said, I was just training for the next show and for the next record or whatever. I'm still training for records because that's fun, but but training for the shows was definitely not fun.
And now you're 19 and I don't know, you're becoming an adult. So is that giving you more freedom to think about what juggling actually means for your life?
Yep, for sure.
What are some ways you think that's going to shift for you? The way you thought about it before and the way you'll think about it now?
I'm definitely going to be juggling more and more like freely and more for fun. I'm not going to just be going out there just so I can learn a new trick. I'm going to be going out there so I can try some things that I saw in a video or stuff like that. And I definitely want to go see some conventions or go to some juggling conventions, because everyone says it's a lot of fun. And the last one I've been to was when I was 9 years old, I think.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
So I definitely want to go and experience.
Yeah, I'm super.
What other jugglers are feeling.
I agree. They are fun. And I'm super stoked because in 2 weeks I'm going to RIT for the RIT juggling.
Okay.
Which is going to be sweet.
What is that?
I wish you could be here. The RIT is Rochester Institute of Technology. So in New York, it's where Wes Peden grew up, and he's actually going to be there with Tony and Patrick this time around. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be a fun experience.
Yeah, those guys are crazy, man. They're really crazy.
They're actually performing in my area next week, so I'm going to see them there too.
Water on Mars.
Yep.
Awesome.
Let's see. So do you have any tips? I know that maybe because of the way that you became a professional juggler and a performer, maybe like becoming a professional juggler isn't something you necessarily think people should aspire to. But if you did and you were like, yeah, this is a really awesome lifestyle, what are some tips you have for them to get into it?
Some tips. Well, I guess if you really have no idea about the business or about any of it, you should just start by watching videos of many famous jugglers or jugglers that are working today, and really pay attention to how they're presenting themselves and how the music is working with how they're juggling, and basically how it all comes together. And then from that, you should be getting your ideas from watching many other jugglers and then making them your own ideas. I mean, not taking their ideas, but, you know, getting creative inside the head and doing something that you like, but also following these like basic rules of what all these other jugglers have. Having the music, the choreography, the presence on stage, and just learning from that and then putting it together slowly, learning new tricks, adding them to your routine. Start off like that, I guess, and then try to find some place to perform.
Mm-hmm.
But I didn't really have to go through all that because I had a very experienced teacher to help me. So I was very lucky, but for any new person, I guess that's my only advice.
Mm-hmm. So the gigs that your stepdad had that you were a part of, I guess regardless of where he was, you did that with him for so many years. By the time you were your age right now, it was really easy to get into it.
Yeah. Yeah. Slowly I developed over years with his training plus my own. I don't know, me, own me just developing as well. So it created what I am now.
Mm-hmm. All right. One more question related to kind of doing this as a career. What's been your favorite performance that you've had so far?
My favorite performance. So the favorite. You mean like the most favorite place I've performed, or?
Or the one where you just had the most fun, or?
Oh, okay. Let me think. It was like the most prestigious, but it was very stressful and not so fun.
Mm.
The most fun would have to be Darien Lake, New York. I was performing with my friends, and they're a part of Nick Walenda's Highwire crew. So I was performing with them. It was very relaxed. It was a very relaxed time, and you know, I was always chilling out with them after, and the performances were always fun. There were people from the amusement parks coming in and watching. So I don't know. I had a lot of fun there. So I would say that was my favorite time performing.
Yeah. You were there for a number of weeks, like a summer?
Yeah, exactly. I was there for a summer 2 years ago.
Yeah. For those who don't know, Darien Lake is an amusement park in New York. It's actually right near Rochester. So that's fun.
Yeah. Cool.
All right. I wanted to take a moment and tell you a little bit more about Flying Clipper, our sponsor. For those of you who don't know who Flying Clipper is, I'm sure you all do, but here is their website. And if you go to flyingclipper.com/EJ, if you don't win that set of prototype balls that you can win today, you can get a sweet discount here. So make sure you check that out. Jim Fitzgerald founded Flying Clipper with some friends in 1983 to make quality foot bags. And then it's evolved into a juggle ball company where he makes some really innovative balls. I've actually done reviews on a couple of them. You can find them on my YouTube channel. Use recycled rubber and steel pellets and crushed rock. And they're all washable. So really cool stuff. And the prototype balls are really neat too. So. You should be excited about them. Actually, Quinn Lewis has a set and he's used them. And I sent him a message asking what he thought about them. And he raved about them. Like, seriously, like, he really likes them. Let me just read a little bit of what Quinn said. Even after just 5 minutes, I'm totally in love. And the weight is perfect. The size is perfect. And the squish factor is perfect. This is a good part. I'm sorry, Quinn. I didn't tell you I was going to read this. And they drop deader than a coffin nail. So that's nice when you drop balls, right? So anyway, Flying Clipper, awesome. Thank you, Flying Clipper, for sponsoring this episode. And now let's go to some more questions. Let's see. From Daniel Simo, are you still training with Dick Franco?
Nope.
How was training with Dick Franco?
It was good. It was very structured. He always knew what I needed to do. And it was very productive. I didn't have to train like 7 hours a day. I only had to train like maybe 2 to 4 hours a day, and that was about it.
Mm. That's nice.
Yeah.
From Berg, Isaac Larange, how long do you believe you will work as a performer?
I honestly have no idea.
Yeah.
I have no idea whatsoever.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I remember when I was 18.
It could end next year, honestly.
Yeah. When I was 18, I didn't know what I was going to do. And when I was a senior in college, I didn't know what I was going to do. So I can't imagine being in your shoes, being at a place where you literally, you have everything set out in front of you to go this one path of life. But realizing when I was 18, like, I had no idea if I loved what I was planning on doing. In fact, I went to school to do something. I went to college for a specific purpose because I thought I was going to love it. And then my senior year, I took a class that was supposed to simulate what it would be like to work in that environment. And I said, I don't like this. I'm not going to do this. And I totally changed my life's trajectory. And that was when I was 21. So it's a hard question to answer.
Yeah, for sure. I have no idea, to be honest.
What are some things you like to do besides juggling?
Right now, I like to read my books, listen to some music, hang out with some artists here in Roncalli, which they're really good friends now. And they know a lot of things about the show business, and I like to learn from them and, yeah, just hang out. Because now I have friends. It's awesome.
So that's one great impact this has had on your life. You've got a lot of great friends.
Yeah, yeah. Everywhere I go, I basically make new friends.
How much time a day do you spend practicing from Spencer and Julie?
Right now, zero, since I hurt my shoulder. But I would say if I want to really practice, which is next week, so 2 days from now, hopefully my shoulder's feeling better, I will practice an hour in the morning, an hour or like 30 minutes in between shows, and then another hour after I finish my two shows. So 2 hours and 30 minutes total. It's not that much, but when you have two shows a day, it's kind of a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's your dream trick?
Nine ball back crosses. That's all I have in mind right now. I want to put it in my show too, but it's going to take a while and it might even be impossible. So, but I'm still trying.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Yeah.
From Tobias 234, ever do high number ball passing?
Wait, what? Say it again, sir.
Have you ever passed high number? Have you ever done ball passing with high numbers?
No, I've never. Okay, well, I might have passed. No, not really. I've only passed like six balls, and then I've passed like six clubs, but very basic, very simple stuff. I'm really never with many other jugglers, so I never pass.
From Felix, who inspires you?
Who inspires me? And years from now. No, I'm just kidding. But that's what someone said. That's what Matthew McConaughey said before.
Oh, okay.
Him 10 years from now is what inspires him. But I don't know. I don't think I really have an inspiration. I just want to become better.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, it's just coming from inside, I guess.
Yeah, that's an interesting, that as a joke that you made me 10 years from now, it's an interesting exercise, I think, to think about.
Yeah, it's pretty smart. It's
a mental experiment to go, all right, who do I want to be in 10 years?
Mm-hmm.
And then kind of set that as a goal that you're working towards being. Here's some quick fire questions for you. What's your favorite trick or pattern to do?
Favorite trick or pattern? I honestly don't know so many tricks or patterns. I just know what I do in my act and some other things, but I'm sure I could learn them. I just never had the inspiration to learn new tricks or patterns. But okay, right now, I guess for tricks, I really don't know any crazy tricks. I'm gonna feel so dumb if I say something because it's probably so basic to everyone else.
I mean, most people say things like I've had somebody say reverse cascade, so you know it doesn't have to be anything complicated.
Ah, okay, then I'll just say what I'm good at then. Seven ball back crosses.
That's what I would have expected.
Yeah.
What about to watch?
To watch. I would say, I don't even know what they're called. Like,
that's okay.
I know. I watch jugglers like Wes Pedden sometime, and he just does like insane looking things using his arms in crazy ways while, you know, keeping it super symmetrical. And I have no idea. I don't even know what they're called, but it's awesome what he does.
Mm-hmm. Well, we'll just say that you like watching Wes.
Yeah, I like watching Wes. Sure.
There you go.
I'm Tony too. He's awesome.
on your favorite prop is balls. Favorite brand of balls?
Well, I've been using G-Balls for a long time, and I haven't tried anything else, so I have to say G-Balls.
All right.
And also, I'm sponsored by G-Balls, so of course, G-Balls.
what is the quality of the G-Balls that you like?
The quality?
Or a quality of them, like the weight or the feeling?
Oh. Yeah, I like the feeling of them because they're embossed, so basically when I'm sweating or whenever the balls would start to feel slippery with any other ball, with the G-Balls, they don't get slippery because they have a good grip because they're embossed and they have like a pressed in inside the leather or whatever. Mm-hmm. So it feels really good. It never gets slippery. Also, yeah, I don't know. The weight feels really good. It's very well distributed. And I don't know. I'm used to them. Yep. They're all I need.
That sounds good to me.
Yep.
What is your best practice tip?
My best practice tip is, I don't know, if you want to learn something, you start from the super basic, from the super basics of whatever you want to learn is, and whatever that is, until it's perfect, and then you move on to the next basic thing, and then on to the next, until you can finally put it all together and come out with whatever you want to learn.
Mm-hmm. Cool. And what's one bad habit that you've had to work out of your practicing?
One bad habit. I guess it just I have to work out how I feel depending on the day, because whatever I feel can totally ruin my practice. So I have to just, whenever I go out there and start to practice, I cannot let how I feel affect my practice at all. Mm-hmm. I just need to focus on what I need to do and not let any distractions get in the way.
Mm-hmm. That's really great.
That's basically it. Yeah. Because otherwise I can, yeah, I know what to do. I can focus and I can accomplish things if I'm really focused and have no distractions in my head.
I don't think that is something we think about too much, is kind of the mental side of juggling, especially when it comes to performing. Actually, I think the first person that's ever said that, I think that's a really good advice or a really good thing to kind of work on when you're practicing.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we'll do some more questions and then we'll wrap it up. So last call for questions if you want to get entered to win those juggle balls. Let's see here. Alex McGillivray, what are the weight of your G-balls?
Okay, so yeah, I saw that in the chat, so I pulled up my weights. And so for three balls, 7 balls, and 9 balls, I use different weights. If no one knew that.
Huh.
So for my 3-ball ball, I use 175-gram ball. It's 3.25 inches in diameter. And for my 7-ball ball, I use a 135-gram ball. That's 2.8 in diameter or whatever. And for my 9-ball ball, I use 115-gram ball. So it's much, they incrementally get smaller the more numbers I juggle, because I can fit them into my hand easier.
Mm-hmm. Is it easy for you to switch between those different weight balls, or are you going to have to warm up to each size?
No, it's easy for me now because I've been doing it for years and it's how I've always done it. So whenever I'm juggling 7, I know exactly what's going into my hand.
Mm-hmm. What happens when you juggle like 7 with the lighter 9 ball that you use?
Nothing. I can still do it. no problem. It honestly, it might feel better because it's less strain on my you know, elbows and wrists. Mm-hmm. But I juggle the bigger balls just so it looks better for the audience.
Yeah. Yeah, that's interesting. Maybe as you're healing, using some lighter balls is a good idea.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. It won't change the technique, really.
Okay, from Christian Houseshield, do you find technical ring and ball juggling? So you find technical ring and ball juggling interesting at all? Do you also find, more technical? I guess he's probably referring to like sight swap stuff. Do you find that interesting as well?
Yeah, for sure. Looks really cool.
Have you practiced at all?
Nope, not really. I've tried it a couple of times, but then I've just forgotten about it.
Mm-hmm. What do you think the primary, like the wall for you, well, maybe not wall, but what inhibits you? So like, say you've got your seven balls, you're doing your cascade, and then, you look at a side swap pattern and you're like, okay, I'm going to try to do that. And you practice it for a little bit and then you just stop. Why do you stop? What is it about side swap you think that you haven't, that hasn't engaged you so far?
Probably just the fact that I'm trying to learn other things.
Mm.
And I might be interested in one thing for a little bit, but then I'll forget about it because I'm more focused on other things.
Mm-hmm. I guess a question that I kind of want to get at here is, and this is actually perfect, is how do you maintain such a stellar focus, like such a intense focus on whatever you're doing?
Meditation. No, not meditation, but I'm sure that does help. I don't know. I guess just years and years of doing it and trying to focus. Eventually you learn how to focus. So if you go out there and you try to focus each day, you'll slowly get better and better and better and better until... Mm-hmm. So you become really good at it and you can hold your focus for a very long time without.
All right. That's a good answer. I mean, you basically just said practice.
Just practice. Yeah. For everything. Just practice. Unless you're Anthony Gatto and, well, okay. He practiced, but he just learned things a lot quicker, I guess.
Yeah.
He had the best focus actually out of any juggler.
So you guys heard it first. Practice and meditation probably helps.
Yeah.
Coming from Ty Tojo, the authority on meditation. Ty, in 5 years, when you look back at your juggling career, what do you want to say you've accomplished?
Nine ball back crosses on stage, live.
For how many throws and catches?
Just the flash is fine. Yeah.
Cool. If people want to check out anything you've done, is there a place they can find that?
I used to have a YouTube channel that was managed and basically made by my stepfather, but he took it down. So now I just have my YouTube channel, which I just created. And it is, Ty Tojo Juggler.
Sweet.
So they can Google that, and I have a couple of videos on there, and I plan on making more.
Awesome. We would love to see you juggle some more and post them.
Yep.
Because, I don't know, there's something about seeing jugglers that are really, really proficient that I think inspires everybody. So trust me when I say that we'd love to see more videos of you juggling.
Thank you. Yeah, I hope I can make some good stuff.
So what are some final words of inspiration to the juggling community at large?
Keep practicing, and I hope that I can meet some of you and learn from you, and I hope that you can learn from me, and we can all become better jugglers.
All right, sweet. Now, I didn't look. I just want to look back real quick before we go. What did you guys say about going to the EJC for a couple days? Is it worth it? Should Ty make the make the trek?
Yeah, they said it was worth it.
All right, it's worth it. So,
all right, I'll try to make it there. I really will. I want to go.
All right,
but there's some time constraints.
Ty will do his best. All right, thanks everybody for tuning in. I really appreciate it. It's awesome that a lot of you have come and seen these interviews every single week. Don't forget that I've got a Patreon so that you can support the channel and help it keep going. And make sure you give a big thanks to Ty for coming on. So until next time, keep on juggling.